I'm Craig Rao. I live in rural Java, Campbell County. I'm a cow-calf producer, as well as a farmer. I've been doing cell grazing with my cattle for 12 to 15 years now. That has made a tremendous difference with the number of cattle that I can stock on the ground, and it's really improved the pastures and the diversity of the plants that are in the pastures. I've been no-tilling for 25, 30 years probably now. That improved things, but there was more to go, and so I've gone in with the cover crops and kind of trying to improve things even more so. I follow all small grain with a cover crop in the fall. And those fields, we were much easier able to get in to plant. There were potholes you had to go around, that sort of thing. But the cover crops really have made a difference in being able to get in during wet conditions. And then this year, it did a complete flip-flop. With the soil health, the way it is, it just seems like everything just works a little bit better. It just seems like the ground can bounce back faster when you have a good soil health. We can handle the stresses that are presented to us throughout the year, whether it being drying conditions or above normal precip. We bounce back. We don't have those wide swings. The first thing I noticed when I switched to putting cover crops in, the tilth of the soil, how much more mellow the soil was and how much easier it was to plant into, using a lot less pressure with the equipment. It just doesn't take as long to dry off, or the water moves through, and then there's also a lot more soil moisture holding capacity. Definitely less weed pressure, so you have less inputs with the soil health. I'm actually using a lot less fertilizer, commercial fertilizer, and getting higher yields. Other than the prices that we're receiving, I'm enjoying farming. I won't have to worry about cutting back on cow-calf pairs or pulling cattle out of the pastures early. And then I've been able to increase my stocking rates, basically almost doubling my stocking rates on the pastures. If you have the good, healthy soils, you just don't have as many stress factors that come into play as when the soil isn't quite as healthy.